Hello, and welcome to Via Church Christmas Service Special. As you can see on the screen, we will be talking about Luke 2, the birth of Jesus, as a tradition in every Christmas service. It's a birth of Jesus after all. And enjoy the show. Also, I'm using 2D mode because, keeping the head steady is a little bit annoying. The stability of viewers. But the viewer stability, I will be keeping it this way from now on. Unless the camera might be fixed in this game. Don't know when this is gonna happen. Anyway. In 30 seconds, you're gonna see some nice Christmas service. Merry Christmas.
Hello, Jenna Galactic.
Hey guys, welcome to the Christmas service at VR Church. Just gonna put it onto the next slide one moment. So yeah, we're nearly there. The birth of our Lord and Savior is almost upon us. So this week and next week is all about celebrating our Lord and Savior. So right now, if it's all right with everyone, I'm gonna pray. Lord, we thank you that you brought your one and only Son into this world so that you could know what it is to be us, that you could know what it is to be human, that you could know what it is to live in our world. And Lord, we thank you for that. We thank you for the fact that you gave up your one Son so that we could be joined with you. And that just through everything that goes on in your life, through the 33 years from your birth until your death, Lord, we just thank you for everything that you brought to us, that we can know you, you can know us, and we together can grow together, and then we can enter into your eternal peace. Lord, we thank you for that, and we say amen. Amen. Right then, welcome, as I say, welcome to VR Church, and first up, we're going to have a worship song.
Mercy. is light and light to all he brings, risen with healing in his wings. Mild he lays his glory by, born that man no more may die. Born to raise the sons of earth, born to give them second birth. Hark, the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn king. Yeah.
Oh. How awesome is that? That's brilliant. Absolutely amazing. Every so often I refer to him, and I know you guys have heard me say it before, but there's a guy called S.M. Lockridge who was a Baptist minister. And I just encourage you guys to listen to That's My King. It's an amazing sermon, and it just talks about Jesus. And that's all we are here for, actually, is to talk and to listen about Jesus, to know more about Jesus. And we thank you, Lord, that you are our teacher, and that you are our Lord and Savior, just amazing Lord and Savior. So everyone is welcome here at VR Church. Everyone is always welcome here at VR Church, which is one of the things that I personally absolutely love about VR Church. Everyone is welcome, no matter what. And that's just beautiful. We at VR Church, we have a vision to cultivate loving spiritual communities across the metaverse. So that's across all the, we've got four different games. We've got Rust, we've got VR Chat, we've got Here, and we've got Final Fantasy, which is our four different churches. We've also got communities as well. No Man's Sky, we've got Star Citizen, which DJ runs. We've got other ones as well. There's loads of them. And I think that's also amazing. We can touch people that standard churches are just never going to get to touch, which is just beautiful. Now, right now, I do believe. Oh no, sorry, not quite. Servant. Okay, I don't know what that means. Sorry, somebody just sent me a message. So if you want to get connected with us at VR Church, then you've got these two different links. So you've got MMO Church and VRChurch.org. Which, if you go into those websites, you'll find our Discord server in there, and in there you can connect to us as a church, and from there you can get to know what's going on in your community and grow and volunteer and be a part of what we do, and that's, you know, come along, help out, be part of it. It's amazing. And now we have another worship song.
To the world the Lord is come, let earth receive her King, let every heart prepare in room, and heaven and nature sing, and heaven and nature sing, and heaven and heaven and nature sing, and heaven and heaven and nature sing. Love.
Right. Merry Christmas to everybody. I hope you're doing well, whatever part of the world you're from. I want to say hello. I know Dumini said his welcomes earlier to everyone, but I want to welcome everyone to Christmas at Virtual Reality Church. I'm really excited. We're about to experience the Christmas story. And before we do that, Pastor Bismuth, perhaps you can come up here and just bless our service with a word of prayer. We're going to jump right into the sermon in just a second. Man, Dumini's looking really good with that Christmas outfit over there. I got a red tie on. Do you have red on? Okay, yeah, you got a little red going red. On.
Yeah.
It looks good.
Merry Christmas.
Before we pray, what's up, Twitch? Galactic is streaming for us. So what's up, Twitch? It's so good to see you. Watching on demand later, perhaps. Perhaps you couldn't make it to church service today. You're watching on demand. So we want to say hello to our live Twitch viewers and those watching on demand later. A couple things before you pray. Maybe just do a couple of announcements. One, we have Christmas events going all week at VR MMO Church. So today, we're going to be in VR chat in a couple of hours, and then Rust, and then as well back here in AltSpace at 7 p.m. Eastern. So also, we have things going on, every day of the week, and some giveaways. So if you haven't joined our Discord server, feel free to jump in there. Everyone's welcome, even if you don't believe in God. And then we're going to do an encore of this service on Friday on Christmas Eve. So those maybe watching later want to be here live, we'll have a Christmas Eve service, an encore of our church service today. I think that's all the announcements, Pastor Lena. Am I missing anything else? But I don't think I am. Oh, yes. One big announcement that I forgot. Next week, on the 26th, we're not going to have official church. We like to give our team, our volunteers, our leaders, a couple of weeks off. So we're going to have a hangout. Pastor Lena's going to be here. We'll have a hangout world that we've designed. And so it's just going to be an hour of just hanging out, chatting, making some friends, just music. Just going to be just real chill. So we invite you to hang out at VR Church. That's going to be all next Sunday, but no official church services. And then the following week, man, I'm excited. We got a special sermon. I don't want to give away the details yet, but something is being handcrafted just for you to experience. So that's coming up soon. All right, I think that's all the announcements I have, Pastor Bismuth.
Thank you, Pastor Soto. One thing is missing what is highly important for our Christmas announcements, because we also try to learn every week a new German word. No, we don't, but maybe this week we try to learn a German tradition that is called Adventskranz. So please speak with me, Adventskranz. When Germans try, we in Germany, we try to celebrate the beginning of Christmas 4 weeks before, and we enlighten a candle in each week, and in the weeks going on, more candles, and therefore, first of all, there was one candle, then two, three, and now there are four candles lighting up just in the week before Christmas. And yeah, that is what we do on the beautiful. On a beautiful circle of tweaks, and this is a little bit of a tradition I wanted to share right now. And again, the word was Adventskranz. Yeah, okay, you cannot hear me.
I don't mean to interrupt you, but I did just unmute everybody so we could say this with you.
Oh yeah, this is cool. So let us try this all together. I say it, and then we say it together. Adventskranz. Now you all. Three, two, one. Adventskranz.
Adventskranz.
Beautiful.
How you say that?
Isn't German a beautiful language? Adventskranz. So maybe next time you speak it with more hate, and then we will be there. Okay. Adventskranz. Okay, thank you so very much. So therefore, let us pray right now. After being introduced to this so beautiful. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for coming down on earth. You're not just a spiritual guy, a spiritual God, and far away from everything that's touchable. Yeah, we have all spiritual problems and you solved it, but our earthly and fleshly problems, those are problems of this world. No, there is no dividing. There is not such a dividing in your Son, Father. Thank you. He came down here on earth and showed that you're interested in our body, in our flesh, in our nature, in our natural life, and what we can achieve and cannot achieve, and the problems we face. And thank you that you're here for our spiritual and our non-spiritual needs. You try to meet them. You did so with all your power. This power is now inside of us through the Spirit. And thank you. Thank you so much. And lead us more into this truth that will definitely set us free if we are open for it. Help us to get into all of the, help us get into all these doors. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Pastor Bisman. Appreciate that. All right, my friends, we're going to start the Christmas story today in a minute. We're going to go walk through Luke chapter 2 in the Bible that talks about the birth of Jesus Christ. And I know Christmas is a beautiful time. I love everything about the holiday, by the way, even the non-spiritual side. I think it's great, you know, that we give each other presents and we spend time celebrating to that regard. But it's also this moment to remember the season, the purpose of the season, the birth of the Christ, God's Son, coming here. And we've been talking about love for the past few weeks through the book of 1st, 2nd, and 3rd John. And what have we discovered is that the writers of Scripture want us to never forget to love each other. We've been hearing that over and over again. It's just an undeniable truth to grow in love. But then when you back up a little bit, where did that love come from? That we see that love come from God in many ways. And in the Christmas story, we see God put his love into action, not just God saying he loves us. You remember that verse in John 3:16, one of the most famous verses of the Bible? It says, "For God so loved the world." And it doesn't stop there, because as we see later in Scripture, the writer is saying love is not just something we say, it's something we can see. It's action. So then we go back to John 3:16, "For God so loved the world that he sent his only son." And I love that. And that's a beautiful expression. This Christmas story, it's a nice story, it's beautiful, it's inspiring. But man, when you look underneath what's happening, the motivation of why God sent Jesus, you know, the one main reason is his love for us. It was a rescue mission. He loves us so much. He loves the world, not just those of us that have it together, or maybe those of us that don't have it together at all. You say, "Pastor, this holiday is going to be rough. I'm depressed. I'm discouraged. I'm lonely. You know, God doesn't love me." No, if God had said he loved something exclusively, I think my Alexa is making noises. So don't mind the Alexa. And if you guys know me, my dogs will start barking any moment soon. So we'll just take a moment for that. Let me see here. I think Alexa's alarming. Okay, there we go. So the truth is that God so loved the world. That's everybody in here. Like I said, whether you have it together or whether you don't have it together. And this message that we're going to see, this story, is about you. Yes, it's about God. It's about salvation. But what was the reason for God sending his son? It was for us. We're a part of this story. And so I think that's something that's important to see. And so let's go ahead and go and read about the story in Luke chapter 2. So we're just going to come over here. By the way, love for you guys to take some pictures. I'm going to blow up social media all week talking about our church services, virtual reality. But I'm going to have you guys help me read this story. Let's see here. Alina or Bismake, if you don't mind putting on participation, raise hands and help me pick some names out. And we'll just right here, Luke chapter 2, birth of Jesus. On the bottom right hand, you'll see this button that says raise hands. If you feel comfortable speaking in public, feel free to click that button. That'll help you read the scriptures for me. But let's take a moment and I'll start out. Luke chapter 2, the birth of Jesus. And then here's what it says. Hold on, let me check the microphones there. There we go. Verse 1, at that time, the Roman Emperor Augustus decreed that a census should be taken throughout the Roman Empire. So at the time of Jesus' birth, Rome was the great empire of the time, and the Caesar was above all. And now he wanted to execute this census. Let's count the people. And so this was the first census taken when Quirinius was governor of Syria. And check this out. When we read verse 3, by the way, there's a little bit of some behind-the-scenes things that I think are really interesting. And here's one of them. All returned to their own ancestral towns to register for this census. So I don't know how it does in like Germany or other parts of the world. The census in the U.S., people just come to my door, knock on the door and say, hey, you know, how many people live here? All that. I'm sure you've been have had some census people come to your abode. But this was a little bit different. You had to return to your hometown. So what city, what town, where were you born? You had to go back there. And maybe you live in your hometown now, but if you didn't, can you imagine if we had to do that? I was born in Panama. And they said, all right, you need to return to Panama. That'd be quite a trip. Or even in the U.S., let's say you were born in Michigan, but you live in Virginia, and you're like, oh, wow, I have to make that big trip. And so it wasn't in the days of automobiles and planes. And so can you imagine, you know, Joseph, you know, looking at his very pregnant wife and saying, all right, we have to make a large trip over to Bethlehem because the Roman Empire has demanded it. No Ubers, no planes, no trains, no public transportation, no personal vehicles. I mean, we're talking about walking, we're talking about donkeys, we're talking about carts and horses. Man, just kind of imagine that. And perhaps you've been through a pregnancy. Can you imagine taking a long trip, not in a nice, you know, car, modern car, but taking a trip and you're very pregnant in a very rough situation? Can you imagine that? It's like these little nuances of the story that I think are fascinating when we think about Jesus coming to earth. And so let's read more, because I'd like to talk to you a little bit about some drama that happened, but we got to go here on our journey to Bethlehem. And so I love this world build, because this just represents, this is like a symbol of this journey that they took. And I think we had some notes about how long the journey was. I think I forgot to write them down here, but it was a long journey. It wasn't no like couple hour type of thing. It was quite a long ways. And this, the world build represents that journey that they took. But let me have someone read, let's see here. How about a stuntman, if you don't mind reading verse 4 and 5.
Sure, can you guys hear me okay?
Yep.
Okay. 4, and because Joseph was a descendant of King David, he had to go to Bethlehem in Judea, David's ancient home. He traveled there from the village of Nazareth in Galilee. He took with him Mary, to whom he was engaged, who was now expecting a child.
All right, and there's so many things that we could talk about here about Joseph being the descendant of King David, the prophecy that we've seen in the Old Testament, this journey to Bethlehem, and now he's on his way over there, and he took with him Mary, to whom he was engaged. He was now expecting a child. Now, Luke doesn't talk about this much, but we got some drama to talk about, just to kind of touch on, just to immerse ourselves in the story. And Matthew reveals that Mary discovered she was pregnant. An angel of the Lord came to her and said, Mary, you are carrying a child, and his name shall be called Emmanuel, meaning God with us. Man, I love that. I could preach just on that one name, Emmanuel. God is with us. God hasn't come down to cast judgment and lightning bolts and he's angry at you. No, he wants to be with you in the difficult journey that you're going through. And I would love to spend some time on Matthew 1 Christmas, but let's stick with Matthew chapter 2. But in Luke 2, but in Matthew 1, we saw some drama. Because what if your spouse came up to you and said, hey honey, I just got some news for you. I know we haven't been together, but I'm pregnant, and an angel told me that I was going to give birth to the Messiah. All right, now we read that story in Matthew chapter 1, but put yourself in that moment. Okay, you're crazy, you're lying. Who was it? Who was the guy? He, you know, can confess, give me his name, I'm going to go beat him up. And so I don't know all the conversations behind the scenes, and I don't know all the drama that had. I'm kind of dramatizing a little bit, but imagine Mary coming to Joseph and saying she was carrying God's son. Well, we know from the scripture that Joseph didn't believe her, because it said in Matthew chapter 1, he was going to put her away quietly or divorce her. Engagement back then was a little bit different. It was almost just like marriage. And so that was the term that was used to put her away to divorce her. In today's terms, we, you know, break up the engagement and, with that breaking up the engagement, it's not necessarily a lot of drama. Maybe you'll talk about it with your friends, but man, that was a big deal back then. But Joseph was an honorable man. So as we immerse ourselves in the story, man, really feel and think about what's happening here. Like, at one point, to convince him, the angel came to Joseph and said, hey, Joseph, Mary's not crazy. She's not lying. She is carrying God's son. An angel had to come to Joseph to tell him that. And Joseph was like, okay, I don't know what's happening here. Again, I'm dramatizing. But there's a significance, the story behind the story, that as an honorable man, Joseph took with him Mary, to whom he was engaged, and was now expecting a child. Man, can you imagine just being Mary and Joseph and wrapping your brain around this announcement? And then now you have this difficult journey to take all the way across from Nazareth to Bethlehem. And this is the coming of the Messiah. And it's interesting to see behind the scenes what's happening with what the emotions, what people are going through. And it gets not worse, but it gets a little more interesting. Let's head over to Bethlehem over here. As we go through this little underclove. And let's all come near the manger. I know there's not a ton of room there, so maybe we'll take turns going in and out, and feel free to come in and get close to experience what it's like. Perhaps someone here hasn't read Luke chapter 2, and you're like, why isn't the baby in like a house, hospital, you know, something? What's up with this stable? What's going on here? Well, let's read a little bit about that. After you check out the baby, maybe come out and give other people an opportunity to read. But let's have someone read verse 6 and 7 for me. And the scriptures reveal why they're not in a more comfortable setting, like this house that I'm standing on.
Hi, yes, Simon. Simon, if you could read 6 and 7, please. Thank you.
And while they were there, time came for her baby to be born. She gave birth to her firstborn son. He wrapped him snugly in strips of cloth and laid him in a manger because there was no lodging available for them.
All right. Thank you, Simon. There was no lodging available. Ken, I don't know if you've been to a city, a town, and you're trying to get a room, and it's happened to me a couple times. Maybe there's a convention going on. You know, maybe there's a big sporting event, and man, you can't find a hotel room, and Airbnbs are all, you know, that's a very unfortunate and inconvenient place to be. Now, add that your wife is pregnant, and now you're trying to find a place. So you kind of go to the room, you know, and hey, you guys got any room for us? My wife's pregnant. And they're like, no. And he's going to all the different locations all around Bethlehem, knocking on the doors. Hey, guys, you got any, room over here? And they're like, no, but we do have the stable out back. And so the King of Heaven, God, who loves us so much, was born in a stable. There's something beautiful about this scene, this moment, to think that God would, this word may sound bad, but it's not meant to be, would stoop down and be here for us, because God is with us. His name means Emmanuel. God is with us. He didn't come in some elite palace and, you know, exclusive only to certain people of money and nobility, social status. No, he was here amongst every man and every woman, just as normal as could be. Almost like this access to the king. I think that's beautiful. other parts of the story talk about the star in the sky and the shepherds and the wise men saw the star and followed him there. I mean, that I wonder if like the world, like, or at least in that region, maybe they saw everyone was seeing that. Maybe they didn't know what it meant. And they were looking up at the star and they're like, what is that? What's going on? Those that perhaps knew the prophecy, like the wise men would come and follow that star right above this. And the time was there for her baby to be born. Let's talk about the drama of that a little bit. You know, my wife and I, we took a trip up to Michigan. She was having a little bit of pregnancy problems with one of our children, but the doctor's like, oh, you'll be fine. We get up there and sure enough, boom, her water breaks. And we're just in a, we're not even from, you know, living in Michigan. We're in Pennsylvania. We're far away from home. And but thankfully we had a hospital. You know, we went to the hospital there in Lansing and our baby was born. But imagine the time comes, you know, perhaps Mary was like, oh, Joseph, it'll be fine. We'll take this trip. And then you get to Bethlehem, your water breaks. Now it's time to deliver baby. I don't know what Joseph's thinking. And I don't know, maybe this is normal for the time and, you know, not a problem. But man, think of in 2021, wrapping our brains around this moment of giving birth in a stable. And Jesus was born into this world. God's love in the flesh. Not just something he says, but something he showed us by sending his son Jesus. So she gave birth to her firstborn son, wrapped him snugly in strips of cloth, and laid him in the manger because there is no lodging available for them. No room for the king, but that's okay. The king is here. The Savior is here. The Messiah is here. I love this next part of the story. Let's head over to the shepherd's field. You think these, you know, kings and queens and, you know, the nobility from all around the world would be the first visitors to visit the Messiah. But an unlikely group of people was announced. This announcement was made to an unlikely group. And I wouldn't say they're outcasts, but, you know, not something that you would, you know, bat your eye or, you know, be too excited about. Let's talk about the shepherds. Let's have someone read verse 8 and 9 for me.
Matman, if you could read 8 and 9, please. Thank you. Matman.
Sorry. I was looking at some stuff.
Oh, it's all good. Thank you. Man, you still there? You able to?
Yeah. Yeah, I'm here.
Awesome. Thank you. Yeah, just 8 and 9, please. Thank you.
That night, there were shepherds staying in the fields nearby, guarding their flocks of sheep. Suddenly, an angel of the Lord appearing among them, and the radiance of the Lord's glory surrounded them. They were terrified.
Awesome. Thank you, Matt. So I need just a handful of volunteers to come be shepherds. Your only job is to stand here by the sheep, protecting them. So feel free to just jump in here and, you know, be a shepherd for me. All right, thank you so much, Andy Dumini. Everybody else, you know, if you want to, you can come in too as well. So we have an announcement when it comes to the shepherds. The shepherds were guarding their sheep, you know, from thieves, perhaps from wolves. We've seen that. And by the way, there's this, the beautiful significance of this announcement's coming to the shepherd because Jesus is called the Good Shepherd. But in verse 9, suddenly, like out of nowhere, it's just a regular night. You're a shepherd, just a man. Put yourself in the story. Immerse yourself in the thoughts and the emotions. You're just taking care of your sheep. You've done this a million times. It's just a normal evening. And suddenly an angel appears among them and the radiance of the Lord's glory surrounded them. And they were terrified. Whatever happened, perhaps that instantaneous moment where the angels arrived and the light must have just been so bright, they freaked out. And you see throughout the moments of scripture, whenever an angel arrives, people get really afraid. And that's why oftentimes when an angel arrives, the first thing they say is, fear not. You see that all the time. And they were terrified. But in verse 10, it says, but the angel reassured them. Don't be afraid, he said. Here you go. He's trying to calm them down. And then I love this announcement to the shepherds. I bring you good news that will bring great joy to all people. Another translation says, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. Man, bookmark this little verse here in your brain, because this is the, for lack of better words, the framework of this Christmas story. The angel says, I bring you good news. This interaction with heaven and earth, this God coming in the flesh, isn't it a pronouncement of judgment and anger? God has bad news for us. No, fundamentally, God is bringing us good news. And not only that, it's going to bring you great joy. And not only that, it's for all people. It's amazing how religion can get real exclusive and sometimes real negative about the message of Christ. But at the core, it's good news. It's great joy to all people. In other words, I got some news to tell you that's going to make everybody happy. That's what the angel was saying. Jesus is here. He's come to save us from our sins. And then he continues, the Savior, yes, the Messiah, the Lord, has been born today in Bethlehem, the city of David. Let me have someone read verses 12 and 13 for me. Well, let me finish 12, and I'll have someone read 13 through 15. And you will recognize him by this sign. You will find a baby wrapped snugly in strips of cloth, lying in a manger. Now, just when you thought it was freaky enough that one angel came and the light shone up, talk about an explosion that happened next. Let me have someone read verses 13 through 15.
Thank you. Suddenly the angel was joined by a vast host of others, the armies of heaven, praising God and saying, glory to God in highest heaven and peace on earth to those whom God is pleased.
And you can read verse 15.
When the angels had returned to heaven, the shepherds said to each other, let's go to Bethlehem. Let's see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about.
Awesome. So thank you so much. All right. This story is getting a little crazy. You have Mary and Joseph, you know, that's going on over there. And then in the shepherd's field, this angel comes. I think Alice had added this angel here in the sky. Thank you for adding that, Alice. Beautiful. And then I'm not sure what this is, but that was added to the build. That works too as well. Oh, I think it's an owl. All right, very cool. Sorry, distracted by the beautiful build the builders have made. But like I mentioned before, the angel comes, light shines down. It's an announcement to the shepherds, good news, great tidings for all people. Excuse me. And then not only that, this whole host of heaven's armies comes and adds to the refrain. Man, what a crazy night. What a story that they could tell the rest of their lives. But let's go back to the manger. And we're going to come back over here. And if you didn't get a chance to see the manger, feel free to come in right here. I don't know if we have any other readers. I don't see any, so I'll just read. Talking about the shepherds in verse 16 in Luke chapter 2, it says, they hurried to the village and found Mary and Joseph, and there was the baby lying in the manger. I don't know what the shepherds thought when they came in here. I don't know if it was a lot of talking going on. Perhaps they're really quiet. They didn't want to wake the baby, or, you know, who knows what was happening, you know, at a dramatic level. But verse 17, it says, after seeing him, the shepherds told everyone what had happened and what the angel had said to them about this child. I wonder if for Mary and Joseph, they just needed to hear that story from the shepherds. I mean, they almost got divorced. She's pregnant. Who knows what their friends and family were saying? You know how gossip gets around. What's going on over there with Mary and Joseph? And then you have the journey. And then you have she's pregnant. They couldn't find a room. Now she's giving birth. And I wonder if there was a little bit of like, man, I don't know what's going on, but this doesn't seem good. But now you have the shepherds come and relay that message, that what the angels had said to him. Angels, maybe a shepherd came up to Mary and Joseph and said, yeah, this angel told us that this child is good news of great joy for all people. And I wonder if that, because here in verse 18, it says this. All who heard the shepherd's story were astonished. Mary kept all these things in her heart and thought about them often. whatever the shepherds had come and told her, it really impacted her. Maybe Mary and Joseph needed that. You ever needed just a little word of encouragement in a difficult journey that you're going through? I think the shepherds were just sent for that very reason, to encourage them. Well, the shepherds went back to the flocks, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen. It was just as the angel had told them. Well, 8 days later, when the baby was circumcised, he was named Jesus, the name given him by the angel, even before he was conceived. Then it was time for the purification offering as required by the law of Moses after the birth of a child. So his parents took him to Jerusalem to present him to the Lord. So feel free to come up here. This is temple, because we're about to head up into the sky here in just a second. The law of the Lord says if a woman's first child is a boy, he must be dedicated to the Lord. So they offered the sacrifice required in the law of the Lord, either a pair of turtle doves or two young pigeons. Now, my friends, come up here, because I want to read you in closing this one verse from the Old Testament. Talks about Jesus. If you're scared of heights, perhaps you want to, you can stay on the ground, but if you don't mind, this kind of represents heaven coming down to earth. The love of God coming to humans. And as we head up here, this is first I want to read from Isaiah. As we're up in the sky. And I think we're going to, right after this, and we're going to take a picture because this looks really cool. And then we're going to go back over to the screen area because there's one more song I want to play for you. And it says here in Isaiah, it says, "For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given. And the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace." It's this message that God has given to the world. The scriptures, remember when I mentioned John 3:16, right after that says, "For God did not send his son into the world to condemn the world, but the world through him would be saved." And when you look at this list, the King of Heaven is described as wonderful. He's a wonderful king. And he loves us very much. He's going to be a counselor. If you think of a counselor as like guiding you through life and navigating you through the journey of life. And that's what we're describing Jesus as. He's the wonderful. He's counselor. He is the mighty God. He is the Son of God, the everlasting Father. The everlasting has this idea of it's never going to end. This love, this good news, this great joy, it's for all time. And the Prince of Peace. I love that. Let's take a moment here to pray. And then we're going to go down and have just one more worship song. Actually, you know what? Let's go do that right now because we'll close in prayer at the end. Before we do that, let me take a picture of everybody. See how high I can get.
DJ, do you want me to take the picture and you stand at the top?
Yeah, everyone come like stand next to me. Because I want the picture kind of going back towards the world back here. So everyone come over here. And we'll face towards the sky. And then, Dumini, if you can get over where Galactic is and Bismic is.
Okay. Yeah, no worries. Get in there, Bismic. Okay, right. 3, 2. We get some smiles and some hands. 3, 2, 1. And we are go. Yeah, it's one. That looks awesome. Yeah.
Awesome. Good. Thank you. All right, friends, come on down. And let's head over back here to the screen. And as we close our Christmas service today, I just want to encourage you just a couple thoughts before we hit listen to O Holy Night. One thought is that, as we mentioned before, the reason that God did this is because he loves you. And that's just to be repetitive, John 3:16, "For God so loved the world that he sent his only begotten son, that whosoever believes in him not perish, but have everlasting life." And so it's a gift. It's a gift of love, and it's given to you. And in this moment, as you're listening to this moment of, is someone saying my mic isn't working? Let me check my mic. Can you guys hear me? It's got a message. Check, 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 1, 2. Hear me, Pastor Lee? Okay, good.
No, sorry, I meant, do you want the mic open for people to sing along with the song? Sorry.
Oh, no, you can keep it closed just because of the latency.
No worries.
And so when we think of this message and you think of that whosoever believes in heaven, also an invitation. Anybody in here, maybe you're not a Christian, maybe you're like, I don't know if I believe in this God or stuff. This story is to encourage you to really think about, to receive this by faith. And maybe during this song, let's take a moment just to be quiet. Let's take a moment to pray. And maybe in this time, you'd want to pray and say, God, I want to invite you into my life. I'm going to put my faith in you. And you see through scriptures this idea, not this idea, this truth of faith, of believing in him. And so let that invitation, as you think about that, let that invitation come into your heart, into your life during the song. So, Adumini, we can play that song right now.
Sin and error pining till he appeared and the soul felt its worth. A thrill of hope, the weary world rejoices, for yonder breaks a new and glorious morn. Truly, he taught us to love one another. His law is love, and his gospel is peace. Chains shall he break, for the slave is our brother, and in his name all oppression shall cease. Sweet hymns of joy in grateful chorus raise we, let all within us praise his holy name. Christ is the Lord. Oh, praise forever.
Amen. That's beautiful. I love a holy night. Pastor Alina, if you don't mind joining me on stage, Pastor Bismick, Mr. Pete, if you get prepared to close us in a word of prayer. Thank you so much, everyone, for coming to Christmas at Virtual Reality Church. It's so good to see everyone. Hope that you were encouraged by this story. I hope you were immersed in it. I hope you experienced it. I hope it impacted your heart to think about how much God loves you and how much he wants to be in a relationship with you, to put our faith in him. I think that's beautiful. That's amazing. We're going to be back tonight here at 7 p.m. Eastern, as well as on Christmas Eve. And so if you want to come be a part of that as well, we'll be here. And Mr. Pete, if you don't mind closing us in a word of prayer for us.
Thank you for asking me to pray. I appreciate that. This is the time of year people are out shopping in the stores. And you know something, individual people, they get to hear the music played over the speakers in the store. They can't block it out. It's being played. And the music in many places and cases proclaims Jesus Christ as Savior of the world. In other words, non-Christian people are forced to hear the true gospel. And I want to say that we buy Christmas gifts for loved ones, and it's great, and I love receiving gifts. But there is a gift that you can give that is the most amazing, absolute. People are looking to what is the perfect gift I can give. And I'm going to tell you right now of a perfect gift that you could give. And that is giving yourself to Jesus, asking Jesus to be your Savior and giving him your life, your talent, your ability. Yes, you have what Jesus wants. He wants it. And you give that to him as a gift. It is the greatest gift you can give. Father, I thank you for ministering to your children here. They've been faithful to this service, listening and following. I thank you for that. And the things that are said and done will reverberate in their mind and encourage them during this wonderful time of year, which is a sad time of the year for many and for what's going on in the world. So, God, we receive the comforting of your Spirit upon your children, upon our lives, that will just encourage us in you, Lord. And by reading and hearing the word of God, that will lift us up. So thank you. If there are any needs in this congregation, I ask that you minister to them. Lord, you know right now that one is crying out to you. They need help. And Father, I thank you for this service that was proclaimed this morning. The word of God has gone forth and is ministering now into the hearts and the lives of your precious children here in Alt Space. They are special and chosen in your sight. So thank you now for the encouragement and uplifting and the healing in our mind and healings in our body in the name of Jesus, because he paid for that. So thank you for the greatest gift of all, salvation through Jesus. And everyone here will agree with me by saying, amen. Amen. Be blessed. Go in the word of God.
Amen.
Amen.
Oh, thank you, Mr. Pete. Beautiful.
My friends, that is the end of our service for today. We're not going to go to prayer world. We're just going to be hanging out here. So feel free to just meet some new friends. And it's so good to see everyone. And thank you so much for hanging out. Let's see. If you don't mind, put on some Christmas music. Just put it at the lowest setting. I think that'd be great. And we'll see you guys later. Thanks, everybody. Hey, Pastor
Bisbee. Hey. Great service. Before I lose him.
It's only three to go.
There
we go.
In there?
Yes. Hey, Brian. Hey, what's up, James?
Hey.
What up?
Hi. I've made a beeline over here.
Hey. Is it going all right?
Oh, hey. It's going good. Going good, man.
What's up, man? Hey, man.
Hello.
Hey, how's it going?
Hey, how's it going?
It's going good. Oh, you see my boyfriend's head
there? Ah, yes.
Still in the process. Oh, stole it. That works. How long have you been doing this?
Yeah, nice.
Oh, wow. 2016
to be coming into Canada, so we're going to love what we're doing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
First churches. We are the first churches.
Well, I mean,
it's wet, it's damp, and it's cold. That's England for you. But yeah, no, I mean, I think we're pretty sorted. We know what we're doing, where we're going.
Yeah, it's really cool. Trying to come in now.
Yeah, it's gonna be really quiet again. Really quiet, you know, just nice, gentle. Yeah, just my wife and I, and my mum and dad. And
like a regular church, like other ones, they have.
Wonderful, yeah. Actually, we were kind of blessed.
So they do all the work behind the scenes. I wish I could take credit for it.
Nice. We haven't seen snow in a long time, you know? I remember snow. I remember it very succinctly, like, you know what I mean? But I haven't seen it in a long time.
That's a picture of
it. Yeah. I was out this morning at 7 o'clock shoveling it.
Oh, bless you. Bless you. I'm jealous, man.
Got my little tractor out with the snow blower and cleaned out the driveway. Oh,
proper jealous, telling you.
I don't mind doing
it. Oh, yeah? Oh, you got one too?
It was about 7 below this morning.
We could come to church, so that would be great.
Well, dude, I mean, I remember when we were a kid, we used to get snow.
Yeah, people really so like now, it when they,
you know?
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, we're not getting as much as we used to because now this is actually the first snowfall I've seen. I think it's going to stay because of the temperature.
Because my little brother has one.
Yeah.
You know, we had snow in October and it stayed right from April.
Right, yeah.
Really?
Yeah, pretty cold then.
That would be great.
We sometimes dip below zero, but it's rare, like, you know.
Next Sunday,
the geese, the geese are still around. I can't believe that they're walking on the
Sunday
ice
after Christmas. Everyone a break.
Because normally they're with us by now, aren't they?
Services with like a sermon.
They should be.
There will be like an event where we're just sort of hanging out.
Well, yeah, I mean, they come to England, don't they?
The next church service will be in January.
They're all over the world, I guess.
Yeah, I guess they do. Yeah, I don't know. I don't really know about their movements, but yeah, no, I guess they are. I'm going to mingle. But yeah, Merry Christmas, buddy. All right.
Well, thank you.
God bless you. All right. See you in a bit.
Hey, Sonic. What's up, Oscar? Did you get the snow out? I want to throw one.
I think I'm going to go.
Sorry about last night. I'm so hungry. Yeah, sorry about last night.
But.
Hi, how are you?
Yes.
It's in which it's called.
Well, I hope you're well too. Have a blessed Sunday. Bye bye.
You too.
Bye
bye. You go hit
What? Adventskranz? You know what I mean? What?
Adventskranz.
Krankenwagen. Krankenwagen.
Hey, what's up? Hey, Hermosa.
Hi.
How are you? Good, how you doing?
Good Sunday. Good.
Oh, good.
You should.
Virtual church.
In like 2 months.
And you can do anything.
Wrap your brain around it, right?
Yeah.
It was just like what you were saying.
Crazy brains are absolutely perfect.
Imperfections makes us perfect.
Did you attend that higher service?
I mean, every one of us.
Like in the physical world?
When it comes to and come together, it makes everyone stronger.
I just caught the last few minutes.
Exactly. Sonic, I love how you said that. That's why we were created.
We're actually
like to all have different strengths and weaknesses because we're created to operate as a whole, to be there for each other. And all of our imperfections together when we function as we should together.
Okay, that concludes the Europe's Christmas service. See you in 1 hour at VHN, my second streamer Phantom. And good night.
Beautiful insight. Thank you,
I'm Europe.
It's kind of a
super excited because I'm still one month.
Very new.
That seems like forever. I remember when we talked about that.
I know.